My name is Charles Person. I was one of the original freedom riders, and we left Washington, D.C. on May 4th, 1961. My greatest expectation was that we could demonstrate to the country and possibly the world that when laws are passed in the benefit of persons of color, that in many cases, certain states refuse to honor that right. The law had been passed for some time. In certain border states, they allowed black persons to eat in the restaurants and use the facilities. But it seems that once you pass the Mason-Dixon line, that was not so. Having lived in a segregated South all the time, going to black schools, eating black restaurants, you know, that was all we knew. So you had talked to people who come from the North and the West, and you knew that something was better for us. But this is what we were all working towards, is to make things better. Nonviolence is the only way. Gandhi had proved it, and Dr. King in the Montgomery movement had proved that these tactics work. When you retaliate, it always escalates the violence. And it justifies you're being beaten. And it's no fun for an aggressor to beat someone who is not willing to fight back. This is the only picture that survived the Birmingham beating. In this center of this crowd is me, and you'll see a guy that has a pipe in his hand, and he's the one that hit me in the head that created a knot on the base of my skull. The word was that many of the Klansmen had their guns, and they were supposed to do whatever they wanted to do, because no policeman showed up in Birmingham. In fact, I don't think any of us even saw a policeman. They just had free rein. I think the Freedom Rides played a part in making our country better. I think we all realize that one person can make a difference. We have to have a passion for life and for making those around you better and for making your country and your city better. My name is Charles Person, and I was one of the original Freedom Riders from the city of Atlanta.